Now let's look into the details of the Diffie-Hellman key exchange algorithm. There are two publicly known numbers, a prime number q and an integer alpha that is the primitive root of q. Now suppose users A and B wish to exchange a key using the Diffie-Hellman key exchange algorithm. User A selects a random integer xA that's less than q and computes yA that's raise alpha to the power of xA and then mod q. Likewise, user B independently selects a random integer xB that's less than q and then computes yB that is alpha raised to the power of xB and then mod q. Each side keeps the x value private and then sends the y value to the other side. Because the y value is transmitted, in effect, it is public. User A, upon receiving yB, would compute a key as yB raised to the power of xA mod q. This is actually the same as alpha raised to the power of xB times xA then mod q. Likewise, user B, upon receiving yA, computes a key, that is yA raised to the power of xB mod q, which is the same as alpha raised to the power of xA times xB mod q. That is, both sides have in effect computed the same key. In other words, now user A and user B have a shared secret key. Furthermore, xA and xB are private, and an adversary such as user C only knows q and alpha, which are public, and y and yB, which are transmitted, and they are also public. If the attacker wants to compute the shared key, he must first compute the x value. For example, the attacker must compute the discrete log of yB in order to get xB. If the attacker can compute the discrete log and obtain xB, he can then compute the shared secret key by using the yA value. The security of the Diffie-Hellman key exchange algorithm lies in the fact that while it's relatively easy to calculate the exponents modulo a prime, it is very difficult to compute the discrete logarithm. For large primes, such as q at least 300 digits long, this task is considered infeasible.